Now here you see clear ridge, which is happening because of taking the knife due to a nail. And here you see the damage due to this nail. It was a very tiny nail, but still it damaged the knives quite severely. So I'm going to remove the knives, see if I can sharpen them again using the Tormag. Now I'm not sure if it really matters, but I will keep sets together. So for sharpening the blade, we're going to use the Tormag. But for planar blades, you need to have a special tool, which is the SVH320. So we're going to remove the standard support beam. So this will prevent dropping of water onto the drive wheel and as a result loss of friction and slipping of the wheel. It's becoming quite wet underneath and after a while the water even drops from the table. So it's also something that I saw on YouTube on somebody doing it, is to put the whole thing in a plastic container in order to prevent it all from becoming wet. So another thing that didn't work very well is the clogging of the stone. So I dressed my stone a couple of times with the coarse side, but nevertheless you still have clogging. Now I bought the Tormag in order to sharpen hand planers, but also the blades for my DeWalt jointer thickness. And that's also why I bought this special jig in order to do that. But to be honest, when you have a nick in the blade, it takes you much too long time in order to get it out. So I looked on the internet to see what the possibilities are, and what I did is I bought the DC250 diamond wheel, the coarse diamond wheel from Tormag. Now it was again an investment. I didn't plan to do it, but yeah, you need to do something in order to get your planar blades ready, because otherwise I still need to ship them, and that's exactly what I didn't want. So we're going to install the DC250 diamond wheel. And it comes with anti-corrosion liquid to prevent corrosion of the stone. Now the diamond wheel is installed. We need to put in, according to the manual, 250 milliliters of water, and we need to add 10 milliliters of this stuff. So they every time had a remark on that you have 10 milliliters, because you need to have 4%, so that's 10 milliliters and 250 milliliters of water that you need to add. So with two caps, that's the right amount. So I did now the first blade. It still took me quite some time, to be honest, but nevertheless it is now properly grinded, the nick is gone. So let's now put in the other blade. I'm not going to change anything, I will now use the same setting and do the other one. Still a large nick. Yay! And a good thing about this plastic container is that apart from the fact that the working table is not getting that wet, especially when you have those diamond grinding stones, when you have this special water in this addition, that you can then also still reuse it. Because even though I have all those things installed, I still lose some water during my grinding, because it's a very long lasting process. Even with the diamond stone, it still takes quite some time to get out this nitty thing. So I now remove the mix by using the DC250. It works on the high speed steel blades, but it really costs quite some time, to be honest, to remove a deep nick like I had. But it's gone, so now there's quite a nice burr on the whole length of the blade, so that's a good thing. So I will now put on the SG250, the original grinding stone from Tormek, and I will use that to polish it further up. Here you can see that it's quite some steel that was taken off from the high-speed steel blades. Now this stone is brand new, but I'm going to take the angle anyway. Yeah, still fits, so no need to adjust the jig. So the rough part has already been done, so I'm now going to grind the stone with the fine part up to 1000 grit. Cutting edge is already looking quite nice. I will give it some extra run on the fine grit. So this one is ready. Now I'm going to put in the other one. So I did now grind both knives. So the wet part is over. And still we do have some metal that was taken off in this round as well. So it's nice that you can see how much is taken off with this magnet scraper. So the last step is now the honing. So let's mount the honing wheel again. Now because of easiness, I'm going to remove this wheel. Just helps making the honing a little bit easier. That's not good. Didn't know that. Holy funky chunky. The whole new wheel comes off if you take out this nut. I didn't know that. But you can take out the whole axle, apparently. This. You see? That's interesting. So what we need to do is to have a cylinder, small cylinder, that we can put in here in order to clamp this X. Now that's not difficult, because I think PVC tube is already good enough. I'm going to take one. So let's do our famous test. So it's very sharp again. Let's do the other one as well. So here you see the knife, it will be put back, no nick, nothing, nice clean blade. So I'm going to assemble number 2 again. So the wall comes with this tool that you can use in order to adjust your blades. And you have to put it over your roller, and then your blades should just touch on the inside of this tool. Let's try it. So the freshly sharpened blades are now mounted in the machine, so let's see how it does. So the surface finish is very nice with the sharpened blades. It's very smooth, I really like it. What you also could see is that the feed-through mechanism of the thicknesser now works properly. I indeed think it's because the knives are now properly adjusted at the right height. In an earlier video where I showed this system, the feed-through mechanism didn't work right. They had to use a push stick in order to get the timber through. And there were quite some comments about it, and somebody suggested that the blades were adjusted too high. I checked it with the DeWalt tool, and indeed I think the blades were too high at that moment. At this moment they're correctly adjusted, and you see that the feed-through mechanism works fine. Even with the diamond wheel, taking out the nick out of a high-speed steel blade still takes a lot of time. To be honest, it was much more time than I initially thought. Of course, I'm happy now that it has been corrected, but I will be very careful and check on nails and use proper timber for this machine, because I don't want to spend so much time again soon. But I'm happy with the result as we are now. So I can use the timber for a new project, which you will see in other videos. So thanks for watching, and see you next time.